On today's episode of Amplified, we will be discussing how you should handle a subwoofer failure. Amplified is produced by Soundman Enterprises, Inc., Mobile Solutions, CT Sounds, and Extreme Autosports. Step one is to never admit fault. When you take your woofer back into the stereo shop for warranty repair, you can't just say, "I blew my sub." In my situation, I didn't even turn it up! My sub ain't subbing, and I was just relaxing in my car. I wasn't even listening to music. And the voice coil just snapped and unwound on its own, startled the shit out of me.
Why the fuck you lying?
I called a lawyer. Step two is you need to call a lawyer. Tell Larry H. Parker that your sub ain't subbing, and your voice coil snapped and almost startled you and gave you a goddamn heart attack when it wasn't even on. Sue the manufacturer! This piece of shit!
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Step three is to yank your sub out and slap your spare in so you don't have to go without bass. Then you could blow that up too. Okay, this is a Focal 33KX. Dual 4-ohm voice coil. This is an MDF shipping plate W7 comes with. Ooh. Four holes line up. Should we blow it up? Or? In my case, I just so happen to have a 13-inch Focal 33KX sitting on my shelf that needs to be used. So we could start by taking the parameters of this woofer, inputting it into our WIN ISD program, and take a look at how it's going to sound compared to our current 13W7 in this box. All right, I'm going to pull up WIN ISD and see what that woofer looks like in my box. The Focal K2 Power 33KX. .800 watts. It's about right. So I'm going to input JL's recommended box size for a 13W7 so we could have a reference of what their recommended box size sounds like compared to the 6-order bandpass that I built. And then we could put the Focal woofer in the mix and see what that looks like. Slot port, 2-inch by 15.75. by 25.375. This is JL's recommended box. Here's my box. Now we'll do a new project with the Focal woofer. If we enter the Focal's QTS, QES, and QMS into WIN ISD Pro, we'll get a readout, a chart on the chart, it'll show our dBs compared to our HZs, compared to our BBDs. dB stands for decibel, BBD stands for Bell Biv DeVoe, which is what I was listening to when my woofer exploded. My W7 was poisoned. I should have never trusted a big butt and a smile. Rafa's mom was in the back seat. Her toe hit the bass knob.
Seriously, don't fuck around right now. Fuck off.
All right, we have to manually enter the woofer parameters. QES. 0.84.
If I were you, I'd take precaution before I step to meet my girl.
Where is it? Where is it?
You think she's the best thing in the world. She's so fly.
All right. This red line is the focal woofer. So by this chart, it says we should have a lot more in the upper bass tones that we're missing. But how much bass could it handle? How much can it handle? And wouldn't you goddamn know it? This 13-inch focal woofer just so happens to be compatible with my 6th-order bandpass because I designed it to be universal. Who would have even guessed? You could feed any woofer to my subwoofer box, and it'll sound good before it.
Feed me!
And you thought Rafa's mom could down 2 13-inch subs quick. You haven't seen shit! So here's 100 hertz. This is probably 80 hertz right here. Here's 0 dB. So I'm kind of lacking in this area. So if we were to retune the current box with the W7, we'd probably want to shorten this port of the smaller chamber. Because we have a lot of cabin gain. This 30 hertz and 40 hertz, or about 30 hertz, really builds up in the car. So our final output here, doing a larger peak on the right side might give us better response. What I'd like to know is, how are you supposed to know how much bass you could possibly get out of a woofer if you don't test its limits? Is not what you should write on your warranty replacement form. You know what? Have your mom fill out the form. You're gonna fuck up the form. The JLW7's warranty void zone is at 2,000 watts, so tell your mom to write 1,500 watts on the... Spray the form with some of that good perfume. Pop your titties out when you bring it in. Ma? Tell them you're gonna suck their dick. Tell your mom I don't give a shit what you have to do. Get the woofer replaced. I can't bring it in myself. They're gonna know I blew it. They're gonna take one look at me. And they're gonna...
Oh, god damn. Oh, shit. God.
I think this might be okay. Still. That's what you should say when you fill out the form. That it might be fine. You know, this is just my loner woofer. This is for when my other woofer's out for service. This is just my, this.
That's right.
Christ, this vocal gets down too. I would say the vocal sounds better than the JL audio, but vocal turned me now when I offered him a show sponsorship, so. So I'm just gonna go ahead and say they both suck.
These nuts.
And now I just blew up my spare woofer. Just kidding. It's fine!
Voltage approaching critical level. Decrease volume and recharge secondary batteries. Voltage levels returning to normal.
This sub isn't nearly as loud as the 13W7, and it is at 2 ohms, so it's getting less power than the previous woofer. But it does sound a lot smoother in the upper frequencies. So I think next time, when we get the W7 back, I want to cut a second set of ports and at least test a higher tune on this box. What we could also do is get more output by tuning both ports to the same frequency, as low as 1.21 gigahertz.
Great Scott!
We may be able to get a little bit more punch out of it. After all, this box is universal, and it's designed to be serviced and replaced. Replaceable. The woofer's replaceable. Not the box. The box isn't replaceable. It's permanent. Got a fucking hole in the cab. After all, custom Soundman 6-order bandpass blowthroughs are designed to be adjustable and reversible, like Rafa's mom's underwear. You should have seen the shit stain on the outside of her.
Whatever, you shut the fuck up.
Ooh, this voice coil smells a little different than the JL voice coil. And a quick side note from my super bass nerds, you could look at this purple line on the chart and see what the W7 looks like on the chart and compare it to our output from the Audison BitTune episode and see how much the 30 hertz loads up in the car. And then you can compare it to this red line for the Focal 33KX and you'll see that this is going to be so damn perfect. It's as if I fucking designed it to be this way. Like it's some sort of plan. What I'm trying to say is I did it again.
It doesn't matter what you did, Doug.
Thank you guys so much for always coming back. Leave a comment. Let me know what you think about today's episode. I'll see you guys next time. Support Amplified by buying iPad dash kits and Soundman merch at soundmanca.com. Become a car audio master with the tools and trainings available for mobile solutions at mobilesolutions-usa.com. Receive a discount on all the best car audio equipment from CT Sounds by using coupon code SOUNDMAN at ctsounds.com. And come down to see me and Rafa at Extreme Auto Sports in Santa Clarita and get great deals on audio and performance equipment and installation.